Well, here we are on our annual food plots, and this area in here is where we sterile disted it, and this is the 18th day of September, and we got pretty good germination with that 5.5 inches of rain. We're going to side dress this with 4600, 42 days of growth. We got rain in the forecast, and I want to show you the height of it so far right now. This is the height of it, and it's right at 12 inches high. And you noticed this forage has no moisture on it. And that's what you can't come out too early. Well, right here, I can show you, right there was a little bit of moisture. Right there was that shiny, was on that leaf. We can go ahead with just that little bit of moisture. But if that was real wet, you could not put dry fertilizer on it, or it would stick to that wet spot and burn it. Now, I've always advocated that this was a learning channel, and you'll learn right along with me. I'm going to show you something. See that weed infestation right there, where for some reason we didn't have good germination. And so this bare spot, the weeds grew in it. But for the most part, we had real good germination, and so it shadowed out the weeds. But you will have spots that may not germinate as you go up through here. And the reason for that is highly unknown why that happens. I don't know, deer could come out and tear it up or something. But, and you know, I just seen something right here. Along this, we're not going to be able to fertilize, because there's the moisture I was talking about right there. We had fairly good germination in here, and but it needs some rain now, and this fertilizer is going to really make it take off. Like I say, this is what you're looking at, is beets and greens. The beans, they've been planted since June 1st, so that gives them 108 days of growth on the beans, and they haven't turned color yet. There are some beans out there that are starting, the leaves are starting to turn gold, but for the most part, they're still in the growing stage, and they made real good beans in there. Like I say, there's a pod right there. You can see three mature beans in that. So we had a good crop on that, and our corn, as you can see, it's drying down. But I'm going to have to wait a little bit on my adventure of trying to crank this dry fertilizer on, because still some moisture on that foliage, and that's the leaf is what the deer is going to eat off them beets and greens. So you definitely don't want to damage it. There's that row of beans I left in here, and they did a pretty good job of supplying browse, but they didn't nip the tops off. For the most part, I'm really happy with that sterile disking method. I tried to show different ways of prepping a seed bed without using a herbicide, a Roundup type product, and we got pretty good germination. There are a few weeds in there that are small. If this really gets growing, it's going to shut the daylight off. So basically, I'm satisfied with that sterile disking method. As we get our tape measure out, you can see that that's basically 12 inches of growth. And we planted these on the 5th of August. But it's time to fertilize and it's time to get some moisture on here. Those big rains were nice, but then it went dry and quite hot. And it really takes the moisture out of these pots in a hurry. Now what you're looking at is the forage oats that we come in here and cultivated these bean rolls out. And these beans were under a lot of stress and they're yellowing up and basically they're done growing. But the forage oats did quite well in here. And this area back in here, I had some, I should have filmed that, but you can't get everything on film. But you can see what I did. I left the beans and in the middle I came in with tall tine tubers and filled in there with the tall tine tubers in the middle of the cultivation. And I had the forage oats in there also. And you can see, well, they really took off in there. And so you have you kept the beans for browsing and they kept on browsing them. And you grew a new crop right in the middle of the rows without taking the beans out. Now those were 38 inch row beans, by the way, also. This dirt and topsoil right now, it went back to terribly dry again. We need some rain and some cool weather ASAP, and it's supposed to be delivered. So, but I just wanted to show you, these were where we cultivated the beans out, which we left, and they did. We pan down here, you can see they did make beans. So there is a food source, and there's actually, the beans are in there, not too many of them in there, but they were really browsed hard. But we elected to leave them in there, and doing so, we planted the forage oats, and you can see they really grew in really, really good, along with the tall tine tubers. So that was a win-win situation and a learning session. Wow, this place really grew in good. This was the no-plow product. And when we came in here, these weeds were head high. And this is micro, but it was all done by hand. And I just wanted to show you the results of that. And this is our number one annual. It's corn. And it did fantastic this year. I mean, and like I say, I don't care about killing anything. I already got my reward. I came in here and labored. I don't make fictitious, childish hit lists. I'm a better hunter than that. But I enjoy just being able to till the soil that I own, that I'm walking on, that I worked and labored for. And my reward is take out a weed patch, grow something of value for the wildlife. Yeah, this is the wintergreen field, and they're holding their own, and we'll walk out here and measure what we've got. There again, they're right at 12 inches tall, but they're under a lot of stress right now with the lack of moisture. But it's supposed to be on the way in cooler temperatures also, or to follow. So this is, like I say, 43 days of growth. And the corn is dried down, as you can see in the background. And we got pretty good germination. Now you can definitely see the cutoff line right here at these two trees. On the right of the camera are the wintergreens, and on the left is this product called Secret Spot. Well, I'm going to be open and honest. I'm not too impressed with Secret Spot at all. It was planted in good conditions. Planted in the conditions that it was called for. And on a scale of 1 to 10, I would rate it about a 0. And I know that's not a scale of 1 to 10, that's a scale of 0 to 11. But this Secret Spot, it just doesn't seem like it did a whole lot of anything. in an area that was supposed to be conducive for its growth. So that's just something that we've learned together on this. Anyhow, on my field, it didn't perform to my expectations whatsoever. Basically, what you're looking at is watercress and a few forage oats that, I don't know, just didn't perform. Now we're going to venture back here in the timber, and we're going to look at that secret spot, which was totally supposed to be the answer for areas deep in your timbers. This plot right here that you're looking at, ladies and gentlemen, was planted on the 25th day of April, and it's went through some extreme conditions, and you can see it is holding its own. Alpha rack, a perennial, planted on high ground, went through pretty dry weather, and I could venture out here. Venture out here, possibly get the tape measure there. And that's 12 inches tall with the chicory and the alfalfa. An excellent product, especially for what it had to endure to get that far along. Well, here's where we planted that brand called Secret Spot. And I got one word for it. A lot of you people would use this product because it's advertised to plant back in the shade of the timbers, and the pH doesn't have to be as good, and on and on and on. And it's an annual with a lot of rye and rape in it, to where it's supposed to be conducive to grow fast. And 3 to 4 hours of possibly filtered sunlight. And all these conditions were here. And to me, this product is a failure. The name might be alluring, and I read the back of the package, and I went with it because it was supposed to be conducive to situations where it's shady in secret spots. Won't be on my menu anymore, because I'm not going to do that kind of work. I got better germination off of different crops that were not conducive, that actually germinated quicker. And this, I don't know, I can see some of the ryegrass or the forage oats that might have come up with it, but far as any kind of substantial grazing presence, it failed miserably. So like I said, this channel's opening. I don't take anybody's endorsements. I'm going to call it how it is, because I don't want you to go down that path either, because this stuff is supposed to have been the product to plant in these areas. And I don't think it's lack of my knowledge how to plant it. It's just that it's not that all that good of cracked up to be annual. So won't be on my list anymore. Yeah, as I close up this video, we had 5 different annuals planted. We had beets and greens, winter greens, tall tine tubers, forage oats, and no plow. Let's see. Let me do that again. Start over again. Winter greens, beets and greens, tall tine tubers, forage oats, no plow, and secret spot. That would have been 6 different annual blends that we had. And out of that 6 annuals, one of them, for some reason, in my terminology, in my ideology, failed. That's why it's important, as I said, to plant multiple annuals, because you only get one shot at a fall annual. And you may be able to come back and do it with your forage oats because it's quick growing. But for most part, you get one shot with your fall annual. And you've seen the results. And I couldn't be prouder. And like I said, this channel is about the truth. I don't take any endorsements. I don't do any advertisements for anyone. If the product, it's like myself, I don't advertise. It's word of mouth. I've been in business for right at 50 years, and very seldom do I find myself sitting at home, because I don't have to put graphics on my truck bigger than my truck. They know when they see the blue and white truck in the neighborhood who's in there. And that's the same way with the food product that I plant. Whitetail Institute, I know they put a lot of money and a lot of research into their products. And with that said, they can't guarantee you anything is going to grow. For some unknown reason, who knows? But a secret spot didn't perform. But out of the other five, they did excellent. So let's sit back and enjoy the hunting season coming up. And I've already had my hunting season. That sounds weird, but just to be able to enhance the overall habitat for the people's deer of Iowa, not my deer, because I don't have no deer. The only deer I have is one, if I'm fortunate enough, to wrap a tag around its leg. Other than that, the deer that traverse on my property ain't mine, and they ain't yours. Unless, when they're on your property, you remember they're the state of Iowa's wildlife. Because if they weren't the state of Iowa's wildlife, then you could hunt them 24/7, 365. But you can't, because they're not yours, unless you put them behind a high fence and get the proper paperwork to do that. And that ain't hunting. So that's it from the non-typical Norwalkian rant.